Hi guys, I'm just going to give you a bit of a quick fly through Luminar 4, which I've only bought about an hour ago, so I'm by no means a expert on it. I've used photo editing tools for years. I saw this on Humble Bundle and thought, you know what, for £20 I'm going to have a pundit with it and have a try. And just to give you a quick idea, so we're going to go on. These are my pictures from Miracle Gardens in Dubai, and as you can see, some of them, like this one particularly, you lose the contrast on the front. So if I do an AI mode, landscape AI, this is actually just letting the program do it all. I'm just going to pause this because the button for my recording is right over, I think. Can I get it there? Oh yeah, I can do it. So anyway, there you can see the difference between the two. It just brings out that colour there, but the sky is beautiful. Look how blue that sky is from the original. If we do, these are just the presets. So we've got deep sky, we've got dramatic. I've got quite a lot of these different add-ons. We've got essentials, which is AI image enhancer. I think that's the same one. Classic black and white. Contrast enhancer. I've bought a few different sets. We've got one called Nomad. They just change all the looks basically. I've not had a proper look through all these yet. There's a Tokyo one which would probably be good for cityscapes, portraits, landscape ones. There we go. I think that's where we were before. So we've got that one. We've got the autumn colours, deep sky. That's quite nice because it's brought all this green out as well, hasn't it? That's really nice. That's actually brought a lot more colour into the sky than I had. We've got dramatic, which has kept the sky similar. Just pulled a bit more colour. I don't really like that one. Impressive, not so impressive. Black and white, morning fog, which just looks hazy. Mystic land, pop the colours, and a winter sunset, which is like an orange look over everything. One of the main reasons I like this program is we're just going to put reset adjustment there, so everything comes back. And up there, we're going to go to edit. And we're going to go to that one, just gives us all the lighting, the AI structure, how much the AI does. So if I put AI there, you'll see that goes up, and then I can actually change how much that pops into the colour. So you've got complete control over it. It is really clever. I mean, that's quite dramatic, that's quite stunning actually. It doesn't look completely natural, I know, but it brings all them colours out for you to see, which is what this picture is all about. Obviously you want to see the colours in the flowers, but one of the main things that I bought it for is if we go onto AI sky replacement. I bought some extra skies. This is just incredible. So this is the original photo. Let's reset so you can see it. That's as it looks off my camera. Now, it was a very sunny day, obviously. I'm in Dubai, it's 43 degrees, and I was struggling getting the exposure right just because the sun was so bright. I was trying to take the pictures only when it was cloud, bit of cloud cover. So if I go in here now and put blue sky, it replaces the entire sky, not just a little bit. But what it also does using the AI engine is you can see there, it's actually changed the sky on the reflections in the rest of the picture, which is absolutely amazing. You can see the colours change. I'll zoom back out. That one's called Bright Blue Sky. We'll have a Dramatic Sky. Look how fast that changes. You can change things with the horizon. You can change the blending, the global settings of the sky, how much it bleeds through, so you can have a little bit of your original sky as well. So what we're going to do now, we're going to reset adjustments again, and we're going to go for a galaxy sky, so a nighttime sky. I was at that is just amazing. Let's have a look what else there is. Galaxy 2, but you can see it's affecting the entire photograph. And even here where I've got the light, it's got it through that light and behind it. You know, you're doing this in Photoshop, can you imagine how long that would take? It's not just putting the sky in, we can all do that in Photoshop. It's actually changing everything else. Look at that, that's beautiful. So there's really going to be no limit to what you can do with your photos. And once you mess about and tweak them that little bit, because there's a little bit of blue in there, weren't there? There was a little bit of the original sky in there. You can alter like how much it's in focus as well and things like that. It's absolutely amazing. We'll put a sunset one. So we've got a glorious sunset. Now let's add another. So on there we've got the sun's obviously down here. So what we're going to do, we're going to add some sun rays. So we're going to put the sun center. Drag that down to about there. And then we're going to paint some rays like that. And it's up to you how much you want them in, how much they affect the picture. And then we can put the penetration changes actually what they come behind. You can have them in front or behind, sort of like that. You can just put a couple of rays up there. Overall look, so again, you can alter how much brightness they bring in, the silhouette in the picture, which looks very dramatic. Yeah, obviously that's no good. And then in there you've got the number, you can alter how many rays, radius of the sun itself that's projecting the rays, sun glow radius, so you just get that bit of glow coming through, sun glow amount, so you can knock it out, sun warmth. It really is incredible. You can also edit the mask as well, so you can make it so it doesn't touch particular things. I haven't done that in here yet. You may have used masks in Photoshop, so I would imagine it's going to be the same thing. Okay, we've gone back to the original picture. So let's scroll down here, we'll have a twilight sky. I'll just pick a few at random just to show. How easy is it? It's absolutely amazing. Sunset clouds. The storm ones look lovely, especially for these pictures here. They look very dramatic. It'd be nice if you could add your own favourites to these, you know, put a little select a favourite on them so you can remember which ones you prefer. I suppose you could go in and delete the ones that you're not bothered about, or put them in a different folder so then you have to browse to them, because going through them to find the right one, oh, they haven't got a bit of lightning in that one. So with that one then, we do that and we go to augmented sky, and now we can add a bit more lightning. We can actually place our own. If we click on place object there, see, we've got our own lightning and cloud there, so we could bring that in over here like that. And again, you can change everything, you can change how it looks. But that looks all right. That looks quite funky really with them too. Lightning 2. So again, you have to click on place Oh, look at the art, it's quite funky, isn't it? So we could add that coming from that same cloud like that. And then in there we can actually knock it out of focus so it looks a bit more realistic. If the camera was focusing on the foreground as it would be, your lightning might not be in true focus. It wouldn't be as sharp as some of the other things. So we can just soften it up a little bit like that, just to make it look like it's genuinely out of focus. And again, you can change the masking of it, but that just takes a bit more work then. But for a general, that doesn't seem to be doing anything. Oh yeah, there, the relight is brightness in there. It's very clever. And then we'll get rid of the lightning. And we'll put a planet up there so you can. I mean, that doesn't work for this picture, but it gives you an idea of what you can do. You could have that up there like that. Let's just default again now back to that one, and we'll just put something. Put a moon up there. So click. Play. Oh, it's already highlighting that. Oh no, place object. Yeah, it's quite amazing. You can it's just a few clicks and you're done. So we've got Mount, oh, that's Mount Fuji. Been there. I don't think we'll be able to see Japan from Dubai, but there you go. So that's what you originally get, and then it's up to you how you manipulate it. I mean, we could hide it behind them trees like that, so we can still see a bit of Mount Fuji in the background there. You can put a full mountain range in. Aeroplane, which you see millions of in Dubai, obviously. One of the busiest airports in the world. You could just go on forever and ever, really. I have a subscription to a website called ImageBin, ImGBIN, and they have thousands of have images. I can't think of the PNG files. There's millions of PNGs, so you could use all them in here, and just have a hell of a lot of fun with it. So I'll just reset again now. I'm going to choose a different picture. We'll go back to that one. Just find something a bit more sunsetty. That might be all right. Yeah, okay, so that'll do. And on that one then, let's do the sky. I'm going to make it stormy. So there you go. Like I said, I've only had this an hour. Oh, that's clouds off the other one, I think, isn't it? Augmented sky. All right, yeah, so you can download new ones as well. I don't know what that's from. Not on the original, is it? How weird's that? That's picking that up again. Must be something in the image that we can't see. But anyway, yeah, that don't look too bad actually. It just looks a bit of like a weird cloud though. Let's try a different image just out of curiosity. These are in Dubai. Actually, let's. What I think these are just off the. Yeah. So let's see how it handles this. Then this will be quite a good one. Because there's no real sky. Yeah, see, it struggles there, but that is where we can now place it, can't we? Because, and it won't let me bring it down. Now there might be a way to fix this. Ah, there we go. Yeah, so is that just bringing it down step by step? That's actually merging the two, I think. Ah, there we go. But it's took it. It's took the top of them buildings off, I think. Yeah, so but that's when you'd create a mask then. We would actually just brush where yeah, where we wanted it, you see, like that, and then that'll let it come in. So this is a similar system to what you, obviously if you're doing it right, you'd use a small brush and you do it all in proper detail, but at least it give, this just to give you an idea, guys. I'm not, obviously you wouldn't publish this like this and you wouldn't work like this. But that is very clever. I just can't get the sky down to that little bit for some reason. But that close gaps, is that, oh no, it's going the wrong way, so bring that down. Ah, there we go. There we go. Right, so close gaps and it brings it down a bit more. And that's quite amazing, really, isn't it? So we've gone from, oh, hang on, yeah, I need to get off my mask things now. And do I close that now then? Because that's done. Go back there. Yeah, there we go. So we've gone from that blank sky to that nice sky, which totally changes the image. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the picture as it is, because that would have been a blue sky. This is the GoPro off the banister and I did a time lapse, but just for a one-off picture, if you wanted to just have a bit of fun, you do it like that, and then you'd put in, because we're in Dubai, so let's put a, we can shrink that back down now, can we? Oh no, oh, edit, redo, oh, it hasn't even let me redo it. That's a bit of a bugger, isn't it? Alright, let's put a galaxy in then. Oh, that works better. So, close gaps, we did that one, didn't we? Brought that down. So that's going the other way now. So, edit mask again with a brush. La la la, well there we go. Something like that. But we've still got that void there and that void. Ah, that's clever, it actually knows that that's a building so it doesn't go over it. How about that? Yeah, it's just overlaying, I think, a little bit. Close gaps. Yes, it hadn't done it now. Or did I do that one? Sky global. There we go. So you do sky global first, then close gaps. And that is quite amazing, isn't it? And then we will put a, we'll go back onto that one. Oh, that one, AI augmented sky, and we'll put some birds, there we go, and now we've got some birds flying in the sky at night time. So let's change them to a moon. Oh wow, that's a bit weird, doesn't work. Fireworks. Yeah, see, it's not happy with that little bit there, but it's just going to take some playing to, you know, we can, I mean, we can always move that up anyway, but there is a bit of a mask issue there, but we can put them up there and there you go, like that. I hope that you enjoyed watching this. I know it's not great, but I'm only trying to show you the brief part of it. I mean, that's actually quite a nice one. I go to warm sunset. Look at how all the colours pop out on night time. That's really good. Well, actually, let's try this Tokyo one because I haven't tried this yet. But it might need something a bit better colours. Oh, that's quite funky. Yeah, that's really good. And again, instantly you can slide it down to see how much it actually changes it. You could have some fun with these. Analog film look, so you can go back to film, you know, how it was when we used to use 35mm cameras. Street photography. That's not a great one for that. Sadly, all my Tokyo pictures are not being indexed by this. I need to delete all them now because I know it's done what I need it to do. There's thousands of bloody images there. Right, so let's try and get a nice picture outside in the street. We've got Manchester there, it's not good enough. They're just cache images off my drone. Let's have a look at that. Yeah, that'll do. Right, okay, so let's try it again now. We'll go for a new sky and we'll have Storm Sky 1. That definitely works. Yeah, it's absolutely amazing. That actually looks like a real picture. You wouldn't know that that had been edited. That's stunning. Now, when I was here doing these pictures and had the drone up, there was a load of birds behind me. I wouldn't fly where the birds were. So let's make it. But there's a lot more than that, so let's try that one. There we go. That's more realistic. There we go, and that's it. You've got all your other stuff. There's absolutely loads, honestly. This is just a quick intro, just show people how easy it is to do it. Yeah, once it's zoomed in and you can see the detail a bit better. Now, one thing that, like, if you haven't got an infinite focus off the drone, it's an infinite focus. But again, with that sky replacement, you can actually blur the sky. There, defocus. So you can knock it so it looks a bit more realistic. If something here wasn't, if something in the background is out of focus, then your skyline also isn't going to be in focus because of your depth of field. So you can just knock it out that little bit more to make it look more realistic. I hope that helps some of you. Like I said, this is an humble bundle at the moment. It's November the 29th, 2020, and this entire package with all the LUTs and everything and the backgrounds was 20 quid, and I got Aurora HDR as well for that, included in the price. So it's well worth it. I hope that helps. Stay tuned for some more, because if people comment on this, I might do some more tutorials with it, delve a bit more in depth once I've learned how to do it, and we'll go from there. Okay, cheers guys, thanks for watching. Please hit the subscribe button and see you soon.